जनरली लॉ ऑफ लिमिटेशन गवर्न्स द लिमिट टाइम पीरियड अंडर विच ए प्रोसीडिंग कैन बी इंस्टीट्यूटेड इन अ कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ एंड इफ नॉट इंस्टीट्यूटेड देन राइट विल बी एक्सटिंग्विश्ड बट द स्पेसिफिक रिलीफ एक्ट itself provided the time period and that is the 6 months. So for a suit under specific relief act on the ground of the illegal dispossession, it can be filed only within 6 months from the date of the dispossession. Does it mean that after 6 months he will not be able to file the suit? Yes, but not under specific relief act, but under the general reliefs under section 9 of the Civil Procedure Code. So this is the difference of the court. This not the court. This is the difference between jurisdictions exercised by court under two spheres. The jurisdiction under section 9 CPC is wider and wider, whereas jurisdiction of the court under section 6 of the specific relief act is narrower, and that too only illegal dispossession. आप देखिए एक और जिस्पुडेंशियल कॉन्सेप्ट यहां आता है राइट एंड ड्यूटीज का. इफ यू रिमेंबर राइट एंड ड्यूटीज आर कोरिलेटिव्स. इफ राइट इज ऑन ए देन द ड्यूटी अराइजिंग आउट ऑफ द राइट इज ऑन बी सी डी anybody else except A. If law gives a right, it means law imposes a duty upon others. And if law imposes an obligation, a duty, it gives a corresponding right to the other. If law gives a right of enjoyment of the property, then it imposes an obligation on the others not to interfere with the possession or enjoyment of the property by the owner. And contrary, if law imposes an obligation that owner enjoying his property shall not be disturbed in his peaceful enjoyment. So shall not be disturbed, shall not be interfered with. So it is not giving the right. It is putting the other persons under an obligation not to do so. So obligation is being imposed. What would be the result of imposing the obligation? It will culminate into or conferment of a corresponding right to other person. So whenever in law we talk of the right or the obligation, the picture which comes out is that somebody is having a right, then somebody is having an obligation. So, by imposing obligation, right can be created. By creating right, an obligation can be imposed. Both are correlatives, having correlation. Specific relief act को आपको ध्यान रखने के लिए मेमोरी में बनाए रखने के लिए आपको यू शुड क्लासिफाई द प्रोविजंस फॉर इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी एंड नंबर टू प्रोविजंस डीलिंग विद द मूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी. सो मेक द पेयर of two sections, section 5 and 6, which deals with the immovable property, and section 7 and 8 deals with the movable property. Section 5 and 6, before entering into details, you have to know section 4, that specific relief act can be granted just to enforce the civil rights. It cannot be enforced, it cannot be used, it cannot grant any relief enforcing some criminal law. So specific relief act has application only to the civil proceedings. It has nothing to do with the criminal proceeding. Now section 5 and 6, immovable property. What is the general remedy in with regard to the immovable property? Cases arising out of the immovable property may be in form of possession, dispossession issues, title issues, and some lessee rights issues, lessee and lesser, dispute between lessee and lesser, and some tenancy rights, some transfer inter vivos litigation, cancellation of sale deed, etc., gift deed. In these all type of the litigation, the immovable property is the subject matter of the litigation. So subject matter of the litigation is the immovable property. The number one general law of the land, that is section 9 of the CPC, provides a remedy having widest amplitude. You have these issues on irrespective of anything, कोई restriction नहीं है. क्या रेस्ट्रिक्शन है? कि डिस्प्यूट मस्ट बी ऑफ सिविल नेचर. सो ही कैन और एग्रीड पर्सन हूसोएवर वांट्स टू टेक हेल्प ऑफ द कोर्ट इन एनफोर्समेंट ऑफ हिज राइट्स गिवन अंडर लॉ और द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट कैन अप्रोच द कोर्ट and by filing a suit under section 9. So better course would be, whenever we talk of a suit under section 9, we should say regular suit. It will be for our convenience and remembrance, and it will make always give it a sense of difference that whenever we are talking of a suit under section 9 CPC, we must use the term regular suit. Regular suit, and whenever we are using a term suit which has been filed under section 6 of the specific relief act, we should use the term only suit. So there is a suit with the difference regular suit and the suit. Regular suit, widest scope, regular suit or simple suit, limited scope, only on ground of disposition. The limitation for the regular suit would be governed by the Limitation Act, and the limitation for this suit under Section 6 Specific Relief Act would be governed by the Specific Relief Act itself, and that is the 6 months from the date of disposition. So Section 5 and 6 deal with the immovable property. So apart from the remedies available under Section 9 of the CPC, Section 5 and 6 give some specific reliefs. Section 5 and 6 give some specific reliefs along with the reliefs available under CPC, Section 9. What are those reliefs? Section 5. Section 5 says, a person entitled to the possession of a specific immovable property, who will be entitled? That is the owner who can be entitled to the possession. So he can file a suit under CPC. Here, Section 5 itself made it clear that if your suit is based on the title, where will you go? Your course would be by filing a regular suit under Section 9, not by filing a suit under a specific relief act. So suits based upon the title have to be filed under Section 9 of the CPC. Section 6. If any person is dispossessed without his consent of immovable property otherwise than in due course of law, he may by suit recover possession thereof, notwithstanding any other title may be set up in such suit. This is what I was talking of. कि अगर छह महीने के अंदर उसे डिस्पोजेस किया गया है तो ही नीड नॉट टू फाइल ए रेगुलर सूट अंडर सेक्शन 9, रेदर ही कैन फाइल ए सूट अंडर सेक्शन 6 ऑफ द स्पेसिफिक रिलीफ एक्ट. एंड व्हाट वुड बी द मैक्सिमम रिलीफ? जस्ट द गेटिंग द पजेशन, जस्ट टू रेस्टोर बैक द पजेशन, अ सूट कैन बी फाइल्ड irrespective of the any claim. ये मालिक है नहीं है, ये सारे issues अगर उठाए भी जाते हैं तो court is not going to take into consideration, because the scope of suit under Section 6 of the specific relief, it is very limited. Court has just to see whether plaintiff has been dispossessed illegally or within 6 months. If these two questions are answered in affirmative, then possession has to be restored back. Plaintiff succeeds. So court will not go into the other claims, other defenses set up in the suit under Section 6 of the Specific Relief Act, because open litigation is possible only under Section 9. Not under Section 6. And another restriction is that this dispossession is against the illegal dispossession. If somebody has been legally dispossessed, Section 6 will have no application. But even then, he can file a suit under Section 9. On the basis of any claim which he would like to take. And second limitation is that under Section 6 of the Specific Relief Act, no suit can be filed against the government. The reason behind including the government against who which the suit cannot be filed is that the state is supposed to protect the possession of the citizens, and it is very hardly, it is very, very, very remote. That government disposes someone illegally. But it may happen. If the government has dispossessed someone from his property, then what will he do? He cannot file the suit under Section 6. Where will he go?
Section 9.
So if the scope of the litigation is not confined to Section 6, the Section 9 is still there to back up. The party can approach under Section 9. Specific Relief Act just gives a speedy remedy. Provides a speedy specific remedy to take care of your dispossession, illegal dispossession. Number 3 is no appeal shall lie from an order or the decree passed in a suit instituted under this section, nor any review. That's why I was saying you that it is a summary remedy, it is a speedy remedy. So this is the final. The judgment of court under Section 6, Special Relief Act, is the final. No appeal can lie. But had it been a decision under Section 9, the appeal would have lied. So, speedy and specific. Four, nothing in this section shall bar any person from suing to establish his title to such property and to recover possession thereof. That is what I was talking. Section 9. Go to the Section 9 CPC. So Section 5 and 6 both, if read together, conveys a clear cut message that litigation in with respect to the immovable property has to be made under Section 9 of the CPC. But if there is an urgency, exigency, then a suit just to take the possession can be filed under Section 6 of the Special Relief Act. So this is all about covering the entire procedure, the entire litigation. बंद हो गया, वहीं से कनेक्ट करना पड़ेगा। ऊपर कनेक्ट कर दिया हमने।